This is What a Weird Week. The moose are licking cars again, you guys.
Hi, everybody, it's Weird.
This is like crazy being here.
Really weird tale.
Well, I got a great show for you today with some wonderful weird stuff.
Hi, friends, I'm Scott. This is What a Weird Week, your weird news catch-up top 10 countdown. If you want more audio, more video, show notes, go shownotes.page, shownotes.page. Thanks for subscribing to the podcast. It's free. Still free. Here we go. Season 5, Episode 1, first published on Friday, January 12th, 2024.
10.
This week in sentencing. A 26-year-old guy tried to sell the late Queen of England's walking stick for charity. He put it up on eBay. He explained he had been a senior footman for Windsor Castle. The late Queen's walking stick would go to the highest bidder. Proceeds would go to charity. Bidding got up to £540, and then the fellow took down the listing because he heard the cops were investigating. It turns out it was all fraudulent, and you just don't get too many walking stick frauds. So we decided to put this one in the top 10. Some articles say the guy tried to pass it off as some sort of joke, also claimed his computer was hacked in one of the articles I read. The fellow, his name is Drew, has been convicted of fraud and got a fine. Community service as well. The BBC article shows the eBay listing, and it's a photo of the Queen holding a walking stick. So I don't know if there was an actual fake walking stick or not even that sophisticated. Is there a market for replica walking sticks? Because a tree blew down the other day in our yard, and that's at least 5 walking sticks waiting to happen.
9.
Next is the dog story. A couple of scary dogs caused $350,000 damage at a car dealership in Houston, United States of America. And there's video. The dogs have been arrested and they're being detained. Well cared for in an animal shelter. But boy, howdy, they went ham on some cars at this car lot. When you watch the video, you can check the link in the show notes. They scratched the paint. They tore bumpers off cars. Why? Why would they do that? Well, it turns out they think cats were hiding under the cars, and the dogs got all fired up and then took it out on the poor vehicles. You know, when you hear about junkyard dogs, you don't imagine them actually doing some of the junking work in the junkyard, but it sounds like these dogs, they may have a future in that. The top 10 weird news stories of the week. This is What a Weird Week.
8.
Exploding toilet lawsuit in the news. This is from the Associated Press about a customer at a popular donut franchise in the United States of America. I won't mention the franchise. You can find it in the show notes. This fellow is claiming that he was injured by an exploding toilet at a Central Florida location. The fellow's name is Paul, and he is suing for $100,000. Some sources say $50,000. He's suing for injury and grossness related to an alleged exploding toilet. That's me paraphrasing. Paul's lawsuit claims he suffered bodily injury and needed counseling after the incident. If it's true, who wouldn't need counseling after the incident? I don't know if you could use a public restroom after an exploding toilet incident. What exactly happened and how the toilet exploded? And should we be taking precautions when we use a public restroom? Well, in the article, the AP reached out to Paul's lawyer for clarification, more details, and they were busy doing lawyer things, so we just don't know much more at this point. It is a frustrating article, but that's about all we know right now. The link is in the show notes if you want to read the whole thing. Look for the graphic we made that says, "No bidet jokes, please."
7.
All right, trigger warning. This one is about a big spider in the news, a world record big spider. They've discovered the largest male specimen of the most venomous spider in the world, and you won't believe what happened next. Maybe you would believe it. First, a little bit about the spider from the Associated Press. The Sydney funnel web spider has fangs that can pierce a human fingernail. Good night, Irene. Hey, they named the spider Hercules. Hercules is 7.9 centimeters, or a little over 3 inches from foot to foot. And that makes him the biggest male funnel web spider, Sydney funnel web spider, ever found. Hercules was found by a person who donated him. Instead of squishing him or just running away, fleeing, you know, and never looking back, this person collected Hercules, donated Hercules, and now Hercules will be part of the Australian Reptile Park's anti-venom program. His venom will be used to help people and save people's lives. Where I live, we don't have any spiders that will do any damage to you, but perhaps for our international friends, if where you're listening, you have venomous spiders that can pierce a fingernail, be safe. We do link to a video of Hercules, and it is triggering if you don't like spiders, and we also link to information on how to collect, how to safely collect a spider. In one of the videos, the person, one of these spider experts, is like, here he is, here's Hercules, and oh, look at that, he's going to jump out. You cannot stop looking at the spider and then back to the person giving the interview, and you're like, watch out, please. I think they were messing with us, but I'm not sure. Anyway, spider videos, right? Right, you guys? This is What a Weird Week, and thank you for being here.
Six.
The mouse that cleaned up the shed. There's video, you guys. A fellow in Wales had an all-night surveillance camera aimed at his workbench in his shed, and he got footage of a mouse picking things up, like clothes pins, bottle caps, stuff like that. The mouse picked these things up and put them in a little box that was sitting there on the workbench. That's kind of the whole story. It's cool footage, cute. And it got shared a lot. It got picked up by the BBC. They call the mouse the Welsh Tidy Mouse. There is a conspiracy theory out there that this was leaked by the Disney organization because promotion for their new movie, Ratatouille 2, this time it's mice. That's just, I don't like to repeat the conspiracy theories. Does look a bit like it could be an animated, it looks like this mouse could have at least its own reality show. Video in the show notes.
Five.
This week, this message came out from Canada's National Parks. Tried to discourage moose from licking your car. How do we do that? It's not easy. They offer advice. Maybe where you're at, you don't have to worry about moose. I kind of do. Like, I saw one on my way to work a few months ago. Every so often, you'll see a moose right in the city where I live. And you can't reason with a moose. They're big and they just don't care if you're late for work. You can be like, hey, come on, I'm going to be late. And that moose doesn't care. And in some cases, moose will lick your car. Right now, moose are licking cars because salt from the roads makes our cars delicious. Sometimes where I live, if it's going to be icy, they'll get salt on the roads. Sometimes they also use that delicious salt juice. Now, I don't know if where you're at, if you have, you know, winter conditions that require salt juice. It's delicious for moose, apparently. So the bottom line is that moose are enormous. You don't want them near roadways. So Parks Canada recommends that basically if you're stopped and a moose tries to lick your car, drive away. They say slowly and safely drive away. I will add this. Having encountered a moose a time or two, if the moose starts to chase you, well, don't drive slowly anymore. Start to do the speed limit, perhaps even faster than the speed limit, as you are able. If the moose is chasing you, step on it. You're listening to the What a Weird Week program. It's weird news.
Four.
Dog eats $4,000. Owners did what they had to do. This one from the BBC, a golden doodle from Pennsylvania, the United States of America, has gone viral for eating an envelope full of money. Cecil, the golden doodle, seems like a cute pooch. And I guess was just hungry, or money is delicious. You know, we all like money for different reasons. The owners had some cash in an envelope for a contractor. So like $4,000 cash. And Cecil got into that delicious money and just started eating that. Let me just say this first. Cecil's going to be okay. But you know when you eat food and it doesn't agree with you, it finds its way out of you, one way or the other. And Cecil's owners recovered most of the money. Not in a fun, exciting, ungross way. The article says only about $450 is still missing, so... By the way, the money was set aside. The money was for a fence. They were getting a fence installed. Maybe go with a smaller fence and then use the remaining money to have some sort of Cecil-proof vault for your cash. Hey, where's some Tupperware? If you lock your money in Tupperware, Cecil's not going to smell that delicious money and want to eat it, right? I don't know. I'm not a dog expert. If you want to read more about Cecil and look at those photos, we have a link in the show notes. You can imagine, though, there's crumpled up money in one of the photos. One of Cecil's owners wearing dish gloves. Also, if you want to read the whole article, there's a dramatic part where the owner is quoted as saying, "Stop him! He's eating $4,000! Maybe this one will be a Disney movie also.
3.
The indestructible cell phone. This is Anna Gibbs writing for The Slate. The article is called How Can a Phone Survive a Fall from a Plane Without Cracking? And she talks about the plane door that came off that Alaska Airlines flight. She talks about how it was some kind of a miracle that no one was sitting in the window seat where the door blew out. And also, she talks about the iPhone they found. Here's the quote. On the side of a road in Portland, Oregon, with an unlocked phone screen open to an Alaska Airlines baggage claim email, not only had the phone survived the fall, but it didn't have a single scratch. The phone from that plane landed safely. Not a scratch. It's quite a saga. If you want to read the whole article, we have a link in the show notes, and they get into, you know, what happened and how it could have happened. How could a phone survive falling from an airplane? Is it wizardry? Are they all wizards over there at the phone company? Check shownotes.page. This is the What a Weird Week show. The weird products from this year's CES Consumer Electronics Show. So many AI things were announced at the CES. AI companions. Some of them look like you'd see them at Disney World. Like, we're pretty close to them creating some sort of AI Pirates of the Caribbean character that just is your friend. You know what? Maybe I should walk that back a bit. I don't know how close we are to you being able to adopt an AI pirate. Maybe one of the birds from the bird show. We put a link to all that stuff in the show notes. And then some of the weirder things, like some sort of souped up dancing plant. Also the stalking you while you sleep robot. The mouth computer. The anti-snore. This one actually, I don't know if it's weird or ingenious. The anti-snore pillow. If you have anyone in your life who snores or you yourself snore, the anti-snore smart pillow detects your snores and then makes adjustments. And also at CES, they announced AI-free orange juice. The folks at Tropicana went the complete opposite direction. There was so much AI, and they said, hey, for a limited time, get our orange juice AI-free. Catch up on the weird news of the week with What a Weird Week.
1.
Let's jump right into the number one story of the week, the 10-year-old girl behind the movement to bring back haggis-flavored chips, or crisps. I believe she would call them crisps. 10-year-old Grace in Scotland loved haggis chips, and when she heard that the haggis-flavored chips were being made a seasonal flavor instead of year-round, Grace wrote a polite letter to the company saying basically it would make her sad if haggis chips went away for part of the year. They're giving her a year's supply of chips and a tour of the chip factory. Maybe at the end of the tour, Grace will be handed the deed to the chip factory. I'm not sure about that one. We'll have to follow this story. Maybe the biggest thing of all is that the haggis chips are back. Sweet victory for young Grace. I like that story a lot. Just a nice, happy story about a young person effecting change in the world. And it involved chips. One of my favorite things. Haggis chips, I'm not sure about. Don't at me. I'm more of a salt and vinegar person myself. Maybe ketchup, the all dressed, almost all the flavors. I want to be open-minded about haggis flavored chips, but I don't think I'm ready for a year's supply of them myself. That is that, and that's a wrap on this week's What a Weird Week program. If you want show notes or more stuff, if you'd like to subscribe to our podcast, you can click shownotes.page and get all that. We'll see you next Friday for another countdown of weird news. And streamers, if you're tuned in live, thank you. Every weekend, we're one of the things that you can hear on Funhouse Radio. Just ask your smart speaker to play Funhouse Radio. Or if you want to, we put a link at shownotes.page. Look for the Funhouse Radio link.